Tevera is building one of the first gamified metaverse on ZK-Sync, a zero-knowledge proof rollup for Ethereum. In today's video, I'll guide you on how to get started playing the minigame and also take part in the Karma program. So let's get started. Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investment YouTube channel, your one-stop shop for beginner-friendly crypto content and latest alpha on different altcoins. If you think this video was worth your time, please hit the like button. And if you'd not like to miss out on our future uploads, please subscribe and hit the bell icon as well. And a quick friendly reminder that I do put out a lot of tweets that are time sensitive on our Twitter. So if you're not following me on Twitter, please make sure that you follow, as these videos do take some time to make. And sometimes some things are very time sensitive. So make sure you are on Twitter and following One Life Investment. A quick disclaimer that none of the content on this channel, including this video, is or should be considered as a financial advice. I always encourage everyone to do their own research before investing or using any service or protocols. This video is not a deep dive into what Tevera is, as I don't have much information to start with. But as the phase two of this project rolls out and as more information is put out to the public, I'll make sure that I do a deep dive and do just to this project. For the purpose of this video though, I'll just get you familiar with the platform and what's happening with the platform currently. All right, so a bit of an overview on what Tevera is. Tevera is, as I mentioned earlier, it's a decentralized metaverse with arcade games, digital real estate, and a NFT marketplace. So if you look on the website, if you scroll to the bottom, this is a really cool video to if you want to watch. It sort of gives you a background on the idea behind Tevera. As you can see, there's Teva Land, digital civilization. There will be the metaverse, the real estate where people will be able to buy real estate, games, arcade games, and a Teva Bazaar, which is the NFT marketplace, right? So, and the ecosystem will be powered by Teva token, TEVA. I'll get into details on how to get those tokens in just in a second. That is connected to the Karma program. If you look into the roadmap, phase one is currently out, citizenship ID. So you can mint a citizenship ID and then get into the Teva quest, which I'll just go in a second. Phase two is the second arcade game, Guardian NFTs, and phase three is a token launch. And the roadmap does look very jam-packed, so we'll just have to see what the team puts out. At the moment, six of the team members are doxxed: Robin Babu, Gav Negi. They are co-founders. Robin is the CEO. When you look at the team, you don't see any game developer or designer or anything of that sort. The team is currently hiring for a senior Unity developer. I'm not sure if they have anyone else. Depending on the exchange I had with CEO Robin on LinkedIn, he said that they do have a team and it will be made public in the future, and I'll definitely update it if they come out with an update as well. So this is the team currently, and they have partners, Blockchain Game Alliance and Florida Blockchain Business Association. Not sure what is the criteria to be eligible or to be a part of these alliances or associations, but they are a partner, or they are listed as a partner for BGA, Blockchain Game Alliance, and the Florida Blockchain Business Association. As you already know, it's built on ZK-Sync and Ethereum. Now, moving into the project itself, there is currently a mini game called Teva Quest on the website that you can play. But to play that game first, you need to mint a Citizen ID NFT. It's free for mint, but you need a 0.0015 approximately, that much amount of ETH on your layer 2 wallet. And then once you mint your NFT, then you will get access to the program, Karma program, and also you will be able to gain the points that you can later on redeem for Teva tokens. If you want to go through this Medium article, everything will be in the description as usual. There's step-by-step guide as well if you want to follow that. So basically what we're going to do today is we're going to mint a Citizen ID NFT on ZK-Sync 1.0. I'll talk about the Karma program and how to get started in the program and how you can earn points. And basically I'll just go over the game as well. First, you'll need a wallet. For example, for the purpose of this video, I'll be using MetaMask. And then you'll need some funds on your ZK-Sync wallet as well. So if you're not familiar or if you don't know how to do that, I have a video on how to send assets to your ZK-Sync wallet using a centralized exchange or any bridge. That video will be in the top right corner or in our channel. Watch that first. Once you have some ETH on your ZK-Sync, you don't need much. You only need like $5 or $10, not much, just to pay for the gas to mint your NFT. Once you have that ready, we can move on with this tutorial. please use the link in the description. It's a referral link, but it will give me a little bit kickback, so I encourage everyone to use that link and to refer other people with your link, right? So what you need to do is you go to tavera.com, and on the top right corner, as you can see, it says already member login. Click on login and then continue with Ethereum. You still need to sign up with the email address. I'm not sure what this will be used in the future, but they will probably use it for social recovery and all that stuff, for example, like the Argent wallet. So just click on continue with Ethereum. I'm going to go next and connect my wallet, MetaMask wallet, to Tavera. And as it says, validate email wallet address with email. So give out your email address as well. So this is something called, if you're not familiar with the concept of social recovery, have a look into that and you will probably understand why they require an email with your wallet as well. You will receive an email with the code, so just enter the code on here, and as you can see, it's giving me terms and condition. Just go through it if you'd like to learn more about that. Accept all. Now, as you can see, it says get your citizen ID. It's Taven citizen ID. It's a free to mint NFT along with the platform avatar. Its citizen can have only one citizen ID, right? So click on continue to get citizen ID. Connect your wallet. MetaMask is connected. I'm going to sign that and mint your citizen ID on ZK Sync. And click on mint citizen ID. I'm going to sign that as well. All right, it's asking me for name. I'm just going to give it one live investments because why not? Save that. All right, so that's it. Congratulations, you are this is my ID, this is my citizen ID for Tavera, and then my name is one of investments. Right, enjoy the benefits of citizen card, get access to future games, prerequisite for access to public token and your unique ID in the metaverse. That's it. So you've created a wallet, you've sent funds to ZK Sync. Watch the video if you're not familiar on how to do that. After you have some funds on your wallet, go and mint your NFT, which gives you the NFT, avatar and the citizen ID as well. Before jumping into the game, I just want to discuss a little bit about the Karma program and what Karma actually is and how you can collect and why you should collect Karma. Karma is a reward system where you get rewarded for playing the game, inviting your friends or doing bunch of different stuff that is related to Tavera, and then you get reward as a Karma. And the idea is if you do, the more good you do, the more reward that you're going to get. So this is a similar idea. So that's what Karma is. And interesting thing is you might be able to redeem those Karma points for Trevor token, which is the official token for Tavera Metaverse. But one thing to note is if you go to Tavera's Medium article, and if the thing that caught my eye is if you look at number 4, it says Karma may be redeemed against Tavera Metaverse utility token in the future if redemption conditions are met and with ratio to be decided, used as entry fees for certain arcane games and to buy in games assets and NFTs. Well, see, it says Karma may be redeemed against Tavera. There's no guarantee that you will be able to redeem your Karma against your Tavera, and also if the redemption conditions are met and with ratio to be decided. In the future, the team can come out and say that we never guaranteed you Tavera tokens just by reading at number 4. So I really don't know if it is guaranteed that your Karma points are going to transfer over to Tavera. So just keep in mind, I'm not saying that they're not going to reward early users, but just something to keep in mind, right? So that's the idea about the Karma points. And if you want to earn Karma points, you can invite other people. So if you, once you log in and create an NFT, citizen ID, NFT, mint your NFT, citizen ID, then if you go and open your menu, you will get a refer, follow and earn. You copy this link and you give it out to your friends, but you got to make sure that they follow Tavera on all the socials as well. Because if you go on Medium and if you look at the refer and follow, if you scroll down to the bottom, you can see make sure to follow Tavera on Twitter, Discord and Telegram. They're doing this to protect the Karma program by the bots, right? Not to be abused by the bots. So make sure you go through this article and see what kinds of rewards you can get. And they have something called Engage to Earn, which will be rolled out soon. So I don't know when they will be coming out with that. Right, so let's just play the game. I'll just give you a brief overview of the game. I haven't played it at all. Game is similar to the Miniclip games back in the days. If you remember the Miniclip games, the browser games, so it's a very similar user experience. Tap start, just click on that. skip. It says here you can upgrade your abilities. That's fine. Number one, play. So basically the idea is you level up your character and you also level up in the game, which eventually will give you karma points. So that's basically it. So you can use your keyboards to control the character and all that stuff. So I'm not going to play it, but you can play it once you've created your account and everything. So I'm going to go to main menu and quit. Another thing is the leaderboard rewards are to be won in stable coins as well. So make sure that you keep an eye and get on the leaderboard if that's something you are looking for. And if you have a lot of free time as well, just play the game and earn rewards and be a part of a project early on, right? So I'm not vouching for the project. I'm not saying anything bad about the project. I'm just giving you the information that I found on my own, right? So if there is anything in the future, I'll definitely update you guys. But make sure you check out other videos from this channel. Regarding layer 2 or specifically ZK Sync, as ZK Sync 2.0 public testnet is live at the moment, and if you haven't tried that, make sure you check that video as well, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and take care.